Hey guys, so I'm back with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys another twist out. I always get questions about twist outs and different products, so today I am going to be using one of my favorite lines from Shea Moisture, which is the coconut and hibiscus line. So I hope you guys enjoy this real quick tutorial, and I will see you guys next time. So I am starting off with freshly washed and deep conditioned hair. So I'm just sectioning my hair and I'm just gonna start unraveling my twists. That way I can start working on my hair. Also keep a spray bottle handy just in case your hair starts to dry up in the front. So I'm gonna go in with my leave-in and I'm gonna use the curling style mix again from the coconut and hibiscus line by Shea Moisture, and I'm just gonna apply that to my hair. Then to seal that in, I am going to go in with the new Shea Moisture Extra Virgin Coconut Oil, which I love this stuff. I use it for my hair, I use it on my body. So I really love this stuff a lot. So I'm going to take that section and split it into two before I move on to my styling products. Frizz-free curl mousse by Shea Moisture again, and I'm just gonna apply that to that medium section, and then do some detangling just to make sure the product is evenly distributed and that my hair is fully detangled. Now I'm gonna take that section and split that into two, and that is gonna be the size of all my twists. And for my twists, I'm gonna use the Curl Enhancing Smoothie, which you guys know this is one of my all-time favorite products. And I'm just gonna apply that to my hair, do a little bit more detangling, and then I'm going to begin to twist. Pretty much for the sections, for the two back sections, I did four twists on each side, and then once I got to the front, I did about six or seven twists on each side for the front of my hair. I'm just going to repeat that all over my hair. I am going to show you guys one more time in the front. For this section, I already applied the leave-in, the coconut oil, and the mousse. And that's pretty much all the same throughout my hair. And then I'm just doing the front section and just applying the Curl Enhancing Smoothie, because all that other stuff is already in my hair at this point. And then just make sure you really detangle your hair. This will really help with the takedown process. So that you don't create a lot of tangles when you're taking your hair down. So I am really detangling my hair. And again, I'm just going to twist that section up, and then I'm going to be pretty much completed with the twisting process. And then that's my hair completed twist. I think I had about 20 to 22 twists throughout my hair. So I did let my hair dry overnight, and it did dry for pretty much a good 24 hours before I took them down. I am going to spray my hair with the, I believe it's the Shine and Curl Mist, but it's by the Coconut and Hibiscus line as well. I forgot to show the bottle. But I did use that before I started taking my twists down. And I'm just unraveling them in the opposite direction that I twist them, and then just separating them with my fingers first. And this is the hair taking down before I actually started to fluff. And I'm just going to go in and pretty much separate my hair. You guys know that I like big hair. I like frizzy hair. I do not like very, very defined twists. So I do separate a lot when I twist my hair. But that doesn't bother me. So I'm just going in and separating. And you can separate as much or as little as you want. I kind of separate each section to about 2 to 3 sections each. Also, I get the question of how I maintain my twist out. Most of the time, if it's like a defined twist out, I do my hair in chunkier twists at night and tie my hair down. On the first day or two. After that, I'll just pineapple my hair if I want it to last, you know, another, you know, for about a week or so. But usually I do retwist my hair at night for the first couple of nights. After that, I just pineapple my hair and that's it. So after I took my hair down, I'm just gonna go in and start fluffing and shaping my hair to the desired look that I'm going for. I'll separate more if I have to, but I pretty much just keep on fluffing and till I get it to the shape and height that I want. Now to go in just for a neater effect, I am going to go in with the Cream of Nature Perfect Edges Edge Control, and I'm just going to put a little bit on my edges and just brush them back with my soft bristle brush, just to give it, you know, a neater look in the front. I usually don't do this, but I don't know, I wanted it to be a little bit neater on my edges and not so untamed. But that is it for the completed look. So just fluff and make it do what it do, however you like it. So I hope you guys enjoyed the tutorial. Please make sure to follow me on Instagram and Facebook. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and thumbs up this video. Make sure you check out my previous video, which is linked to the left. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!